Distinguished dignitaries on the dais, guests from India and abroad, ladies and gentlemen, I'm very happy to be here at the inauguration of the World Sustainable Development Summit. To those joining us from abroad, welcome to India. Welcome to Delhi. On the sidelines of the summit, I hope you shall have some time to see the history and splendor of this city. This summit is a reinforcement of India's commitment to a sustainable planet for ourselves and for future generations. As a nation, we are proud of our long history and tradition of harmonious coexistence between man and nature. Respect for nature is an integral part of our value system. Our traditional practices contribute to a sustainable lifestyle. Our goal is to be able to live up to our ancient texts, which say, keep pure, for the earth is our mother and we are her children. One of the most ancient scriptures, the Atharva Ved, spells out, Mata Bhumihi Putro Aham Prithivyam. This is the ideal we seek to live through our actions. We believe that all resources and all wealth belongs to nature and the Almighty. We are just the trustees for or managers of this wealth. Mahatma Gandhi too advocated this trusteeship philosophy. Recently, National Geographic's Grindex report of 2014, which assesses the environmental sustainability of consumer choice, ranked India at the top for its greenest consumption pattern. Over the years, the World Sustainable Development Summit has spread consciousness about our actions to preserve the purity of Mother Earth to all parts of the world. This common desire was on display at COP21 in Paris in 2015. Nations took a stand to come together and work toward the common cause of sustaining our planet. As the world committed to bring about change, so did we. While the world was discussing inconvenient truth, we translated it into convenient action. India believes in growth, but is also committed to protecting the environment. Friends, it was with this thought that India, along with France, initiated the International Solar Alliance. It already has 121 members. It is perhaps the single most important global achievement after Paris. As part of the nationally determined contributions, India committed to reducing 33 to 35% of emission intensity of its GDP during 2005 to 2030. Our goal of creating a carbon sink of 2.5 to 3 billion tons of carbon dioxide environment equivalent by 2030 had once seemed difficult to many. Yet, we continue our steady progress on that path. According to the UNEP GAP report, India is on track to meet its Copenhagen pledge of reducing the emission intensity of its GDP by 20 to 25% over 2005 levels by 2020. We are also on track to meet the 2030 nationally determined contribution. The UN Sustainable Development Goals puts us on the path of equality, equity, and climate justice. While we are doing everything that is required of us, we expect that others also join in to fulfill their commitments based on common but differentiated responsibility and equity. We must also stress on climate justice for all vulnerable populations. We in India are focused on ease of living through good governance, sustainable livelihood, and through cleaner environment. The campaign for Clean India has moved from the streets of Delhi to every nook and corner of the country. Cleanliness leads to better hygiene, better health, better working condition, and thereby better income and life. We have also launched a massive campaign to ensure that our farmers convert agriculture waste to valuable nutrients instead of burning them. We are also happy to host the 2018 World Environment Day to highlight our commitment and our continuing partnership to make the world a cleaner place. We also recognize the need to tackle the issue of water availability, which is becoming a major challenge. That is why we have introduced the massive Namami Gange initiative. This program, which has already started giving results, will soon revive the Ganga, our most precious river. Our country is primarily agrarian. Continued availability of water for agriculture is of importance. The Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sinchai Yojana has been launched to ensure that no farm goes without water. Our motto is more crop per drop. India has a fairly decent report card on biodiversity conservation. With only 2.4% of the world's land area, India harbors 7 to 8% of the recorded species diversity while supporting nearly 18% of human population. India has gained international recognition for 10 out of its 18 biosphere reserves under UNESCO's Man and Biosphere Program. This is a testimony that our development is green and our wildlife is robust. Friends, India has always believed in making the benefits of good governance reach everyone. Our mission of Sabka Saath Sabka Vikas is an extension of this philosophy. Through this philosophy, we are ensuring that some of our most deprived areas experience social and economic progress on par with others. In this day and age, access to electricity and clean cooking solutions are basics that every person must be provided with. These form the core of the country's economic development. Yet, there are many in India and outside who are struggling in the absence of these solutions. People are forced to use unhealthy cooking techniques that causes indoor air pollution. I have been told that the smoke in a rural kitchen resulting from this is a serious health hazard. Yet, few talk about it. Keeping this in view, we have launched two far-reaching initiatives, Ujwala and Saubhagya. From the time that they were launched, these schemes have already impacted the lives of millions. With these twin programs, the time when mothers would fetch dry wood from forest or prepare cow dung cakes to feed their families will be gone soon. Soon too, the images of traditional firewood stoves will only remain in a picture in our social history texts. Similarly, through Saubhagya scheme, we are working towards electrifying every household in this country mostly by the end of this year. We recognize that only a healthy nation can lead the process of development. Keeping this in mind, we have launched the world's largest government-funded health scheme. The program will support 100 million poor families. Our Housing for All and Power for All initiatives also stem from this same agenda of providing the basic amenities of life to those who cannot afford them. Friends, you know that India is 1/6 of the global community. Our development needs are enormous. Our poverty, our prosperity will have direct impact on the global poverty or prosperity. People in India have waited too long for access to modern amenities and means of development. We have committed to complete this task sooner than anticipated. However, we have also said that we will do all this in a cleaner and greener way. To give you just a few examples, we are a young nation. To give employment to our youth, we have decided to make in India a global manufacturing hub. We have launched the Make in India campaign for this. However, at the same time, we are insisting on zero defect, zero effect manufacturing. As the world's fastest growing major economy, our energy needs are immense. However, we have planned to draw 175 gigawatts of energy from renewable sources by 2022. This includes 100 gigawatts from solar energy and another 75 gigawatts from wind and other sources. We have added more than 14 gigawatts to solar energy generation, which was just about 3 gigawatts 3 years back. With this, we are already the fifth largest producer of solar energy in the world. Not only this, we are also the sixth largest producer of renewable energy. With growing urbanization, our transportation needs are growing too. But we are focusing on mass transportation systems, especially metro rail systems. Even for cargo movement, to long distances, we have started working on national waterway systems. Each of our states is preparing an action plan against climate change. This will ensure that while we are working towards conserving our environment, we also safeguard our most vulnerable areas. One of our largest states, Maharashtra, has already adopted a plan of its own in this direction. We intend to achieve each of our sustainable development objectives on our own, but collaboration remains the key. Collaboration between governments, between industries, and between people. The developed world can help us achieve them faster. Successful climate action needs access to financial resources and technology. Technology can help countries like India develop sustainably and enable the poor to benefit from it. Friends, we are here today to act upon the belief that we as humans can make a difference to this planet. We need to understand that this planet, our Mother Earth, is one. And so we should rise above our trivial differences of race, religion, and power and act as one to save her. With our deep-rooted philosophy of coexistence with nature and coexistence with each other, we invite you to join us in the journey of making this planet a more safe and sustainable place. I wish the World Sustainable Development Summit a great success. Thank you. Thank you very much.